It's time for Snapple to once again face the nation. Josh Spiegel's favorite beverage, Diet Peach Snapple, in the glass bottle, recently moved to a new recyclable, more environmentally friendly plastic bottle. Josh tries it. He immediately realizes it's far too sweet. They must have changed the formula. He tweets at Snapple saying, "What have you done? What happened to my favorite beverage?" They respond.
Wow.
They deny the allegation, saying, "No, only the bottle has changed. Josh, it's merely just a new recyclable, environmentally friendly plastic bottle. Oh, click this link to read more and find out for yourself." How about this? Yo, link, homie. How about that?
Can you see, are other people, can you see any other interaction of Snapple on Twitter where maybe people are saying the same thing?
Scott, you're inside of my head. I already have that pulled up for you. Here we are. If you just search Snapple Taste on Twitter, you find some of the same. Snapple, what happened? I used to remember your Go Bananas flavored juice drink was delicious. You moved to the plastic bottle and now it tastes different. Another man posting a photo of the standard peach Snapple bottle says Snapple in the glass just hits different. Why does the plastic taste so much different? People are going off about the Snapple apple. Apparently, the Snapple apple is the most egregious of the new ones. They say it tastes
flavors
now,
totally off.
Like, oh, the apple juice one?
The apple says it's like drinking a liquid apple. But yeah, not in a good way. Like, it's syrupy. It tastes different.
Yeah, apparently all of us are complete idiots, according to Snapple.
Now, they had to have taken into account the way the medium in which the liquid is delivered would affect the taste.
I want blood.
See, you figure as a company as giant as Snapple, which apparently is owned by Keurig and Dr. Pepper at this point, that they would have had research done as to whether or not going to plastic would affect the taste. And I guess they came to the conclusion that it wouldn't, but here we are.
Here we are. Now let's continue our research here because that's what we do so well. Reader's Digest, March 29th, 2021.
Oh.
Why do beverages taste so much better in glass bottles?
Because glass isn't as porous.
Exactly. Plastic bottles have an acetylene.
There you go.
They have an ass lining, which can transfer into the flavor of the drink, given a slightly plasticky taste. Sometimes it can make the drink appear to be more sour. Sometimes it can make the drink appear to be more sweet. Uh-huh. But it can alter the flavor of the beverage compared to the more sealed taste of a glass bottle.
It's an outrage.
So the plastic bottle definitely has affected the flavor of the drink. I placed the bottle in question in front of you, Scott. You have, the new plastic bottle. You want to hold that up for the live wire camera? There it is right there.
What camera am I looking at? Camera two? Camera one?
Is the offending bottle, okay? I already don't like the logo.
Yeah.
I already don't like the shape.
I don't like the look of it. I don't like the shape of it.
Why do they have to change it for?
It's the environment.
The turtles, Josh.
So do you want to hear my tweet that I just sent Snapple about 10 minutes ago? Because I sent them a tweet yesterday, as he mentioned. Okay. About to do a taste test on JSS 98 Rock as I look for a new drink after I've been forced to give up my favorite drink for years, Diet Peach at Snapple.
Yeah.
Because of an obvious change in sweetness. I wasn't born yesterday. I know too sweet when I taste it. Join the revolution.
Yeah. Join the revolution. Yeah.
You dirty bitch.
Oh, yeah.
I have it. I'm going to taste it. My palate is not as in sync with what this would normally taste like.
It might taste fine to you, but you weren't really a Diet Peach Snapple drinker.
My tongue has a lot of experience.
I'll say,
oh, enjoy it. That's most important.
See, I tasting that, it does taste sweeter than the normal diet, but I, like you said, I'm not as acclimated. I don't mind. That's actually very good.
I'm sorry. Would you?
But
say
I'm not
that
used to the
getting interference.
I'm not used to the regular formula.
So you don't have like a baseline. You give
me
a sweet
baseline,
spicy,
but I can tell that it is sweeter. But I enjoy. I may be on the train.
Oh no!
They may have lost one customer and gained another.
Well, let's try this.
Take a sip. That is good.
There you go.
But yes, it is.
It's sweet. Yeah, man, I can't do the aspartame. Oh, I can't. I'm not an artificial sweetener guy. One carb, zero sugars.
I only took two sips. The whole bottle of that might wreck you.
Yeah.
It does seem.
You know what happens?
It lingers. Coats.
It coats your tongue.
Coats.
I feel like there's a lacquer coating. I feel like I got my tongue detailed with a paint protection and sealant. So I don't like it. I don't like it. I'm not just saying that. I just
maybe
don't
over ice?
Like...
Try it over ice?
Might maybe.
Knock it down a bit?
Smoke a little ice.
All right. So we got you three new ones here. The first one right there I can tell is already out because it's 110 calories. You don't want that.
Well, you never know. You never know. I don't know how I would alter that, but...
That's a Lipton Georgia Peach.
Yeah, I had a son of a bitch of a time trying to find you something comparable. Oh, so what I found, you know, in place of a Diet Peach Snapple, I found you a peach iced tea, a diet iced tea,
yes,
and then a healthy one that was completely unsweetened.
Okay.
So what's the first one that you have?
Lipton Georgia Peach, 110 calories. How's it hitting the nose?
I like the smell. It's okay. Not too strong. Now, did you aerate this?
I did not aerate.
Okay. And I see there's no pot for me to spit into.
Bring in the sommelier.
There it goes. Ooh,
ooh. It's going to be too sweet.
It's sweet. It's not. Yeah, it's too sweet.
It's got to be too sweet because it's full flavor.
Yeah, it's a little too sweet. Not as sweet as the new Snapple stuff.
Mm-hmm. Bastards.
Okay, I've got to put that over there. This one is, what should I try? The Royal Farms? That looks good.
Yeah, what's the other one? Shout out Rofo.
Rofo is diet, which is good.
Yeah, I found you a diet one. Now, okay. This is diet. What flavor?
Lemon flavor.
Yeah, I couldn't find a peach, but I did find you a diet tea. Here you go.
The smell is not at all overwhelming. I like that.
Oh, God.
Yeah.
That's good. I like that.
Is that wait, I missed it.
I like
is that.
That
diet or not diet?
Diet iced tea.
Okay, that's the diet lemon from Rofo.
You know what else has always been a strong contender for me is Turkey Hill. You ever mess with Turkey Hill?
I wanted to find some Turkey Hill and I couldn't.
Oh my God, Turkey Hill. I've never had the iced tea. The lemonade is amazing. Oh,
and yeah, they got a good diet line of
they
teas.
Do?
Oh yeah,
my pal John Mooma tells a story about growing up in Lancaster, PA, and in middle school they went to a field trip to the Turkey Hill iced tea facility. And the guy, when they went up into the brewing area, was like, man, I drink about a gallon of this stuff a day, and I can't get enough of it. I love the product, and I believe in it. He smiles, three teeth.
Aww.
Just jet black fangs. That's what happens when you drink that much.
This is unsweetened black tea, real brewed tea, pure leaf, I guess is the brand. First problem is I haven't even smelled it yet. It's about to come spilling out of the
top. Yeah. This is going to have no sweetness to it.
Yeah, this is, I don't like this.
Zero sweetness.
Yeah, this smells like a tea bag.
I'll tell you what, though. You drink that unsweetened pure leaf black tea for like a week and your palate adjusts. It's good stuff.
Yeah, you can get used to it. Like, I enjoy a cold brew without sweetness.
Yeah, I mean, it's
tea, man.
Yeah, it's there's really no flavor. It's like a tea bag.
It's pure tea.
Yeah.
I was trying to find something that was diet, something with no sugar, and something peach. I figured that one might be the least favorite.
Given in a little more thought.
Sorry about that.
Thank you. It's if you got some interesting choices. I really like the Royal Farms.
I heard Royal Farms is great. Wawa is good, I've heard, and Turkey Hill. So maybe we'll figure that out.
Yeah, I got
none of these are maybe the Royal Farms,
the Rofo to scratch the itch.
Yeah, I could definitely get into Royal Farms. I mean, Royal Farms is much better than the Snapple thing.
Oh damn,
go off, King. Can I try the unsweetened one? Sure. Mind you, that's the what's that? The pure leaf.
Oh yeah,
I think they're bottled.
Have this.
Can I tell you too?
The problem I have with those pure leaf ones that are unsweetened, they almost leave you more thirsty.
Real pretentious looking bottle.
Yeah.
This bottle says I went to college, and I'm going to tell you exactly where I went, even if you didn't ask. Let's try this. All right. This is the unsweetened black. Mm-hmm. Oh, Christ, that's bitter. Oh, yeah. Mm-mm. Nope. Maybe to make an ice pick or something like that. Ooh. Put a little Tito's in that bad boy. A little Deep Eddie's lemon. I'll do unsweetened iced tea with Deep Eddie's lemon to make like an Arnold Palmer.
Now, you mentioned that Snapple was owned in part by Keurig?
Last time I looked, Snapple was under the umbrella of Keurig Dr. Pepper.
Is that the company that makes K-Cups?
That's correct.
Perhaps Snapple and I could make a deal, because I drink loads of K-Cups every day. This may turn into a bribery extortion situation.
What are your demands?
Lifetime supply of Kirk K-Cups.
If you agree to return to the new flavor of Snapple in the new bottle in exchange, they send you, they flow you, flex you, cases of K-Cups.
Yeah,
I remain
will.
Brand loyal.
If they send me lifetime supply of K-Cups and also Keurig machines, like constantly, new ones every few months, I will go back on the air and lie and say that I like the Snapple.
You have our demands, Snapple. You now know what you need to bring to the table to retain a five-time, that's right.
Five-time!
Murrow Award-winning tea drinkers
now,
loyalty.
Here's the situation. I got it in my next tweet, and I'm assuming there will be a tweet because Snapple is assuming that they will not reply to my latest revolutionary tweet. I might have to drop in a, hey, I love Keurig, but this Snapple is, and then they might...
Trying to leverage
them. Yeah, if they have any common sense, they'll get the message.
I think they don't know who they're dealing with.
Yeah, people are picking sides, too, and let me tell you what, there ain't a whole lot of people siding with the best stuff on Earth. Kenny the Waffle says, I feel like I'm about to watch a playground fight, and you just know who's going to win. Poor Snapple, you will be missed. Hey, Snapple. You really screwed up. Uh-oh. Snapple done gone f***ed up. Hashtag justice for Josh. Hashtag RIP Snapple. All right. The ball is in their Diet Peach court.